What up, agents? Prime here. Yes, Tuesday again, vendor reset day. So let's see what the vendor sells us, shall we? Are you ready? Let's go! What up, guys? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content. Really appreciate you watching. And it's Tuesday, so let's see what all the vendors sell us. Starting at the White House, Walker and Harris, the chain killer, pretty decent. 11.8% weapon damage, 8.2% hazard protection, 6.8% headshot damage, and of course the perfect head under on there. Roll that hazard protection away from some crit or crit damage and you're Gucci. I'm not liking the guns, not liking it at all. Maybe the X45 to pick up for your pistol damage. I don't know why, but I cannot roll the pistol damage higher in my library. I have a few of 15%, but it doesn't work. Over to the Petrov backpack, decent one as well. In my opinion, roll that tech support away, the rest is rats. Over to the Overlord Fest, not that great if you ask me. Then we got 9.9% critical hit damage, 6.3% duration for your drone, 4.3% damage for your turret, and 5% blast radius, so not that great. Let's see what the clan vendor sells us. And there we are, guys, at the clan vendor, 27 till 30, and the first piece we can pick up is the Mozambique special, but just leave it here, guys. It's just a pistol, 15k for this pistol, no thanks. 14% weapon damage on tip of the spear, pretty decent. Roll that skill haste away for wherever you need. 145 armor on a mask and 4.7% critical hit chance. This is a pretty decent buy, especially if you want to go for all red true patriot. That's pretty OP. Over to the striker knees, 13.9% weapon damage. Could be nice. We cannot craft this, so this could be a nice buy. Roll that explosive resistance away from some reds. PX Storm, no thank you. The SOCOM MK20, no thank you. Black Market M60, no thank you. Araldi Holdings could be a very, very nice buy, guys. Critical hit damage almost at that max cap, 0.2% away. 12.9% weapon damage is pretty decent, and roll that explosive resistance away, but then I see the talent, explosive delivery. Never mind, this is trash. 6716, not that great if you ask me. If you like to pick that up, roll that reload speed away. Knee pads from Overlord, pretty decent, but in my opinion, go for the named ones. Mask from Walker and Harris, could be nice if you're looking for a combination of Walker and Harris and hazard protection. Roll it health away because the weapon damage is decent enough. Then we got 18% incoming repair, pretty high up there. 4.7% critical hit chance, 4.4% shield health, could be nice, and 8.7% health for your drone. But that's it for the clan, guys. Let's jump over to the campus. And there we are, guys, at the campus. First thing is a designated hitter, but just leave it here. You can farm it in the open world, 15k, too much to buy. It's not that great of a gun. Then over to the G28, just leave it here. Classic RPK, just leave it here. Then this is not a great mask for China as well. And then we got the Sokolov holster, that could be nice. Roll that status effect away for some critical hit chance. Over to the 10.2% skill haste, 6% radius, 4 repair charges, pick it up if you still need it. This is the max. And we got 8.8 radius and 5.7% shock radius. So not that great. Let's head over to the theater. And there we are, guys, at the theater. The first thing is the Baker's Dozen, and just leave it here, guys. If you're still looking for this and you don't have the roll that you can buy right now, roll that rifle damage away, or of course a little bit higher. You have a pretty decent one, but still open world, way better chances. Then we got the M870 with 12% damage to armor, the max cap, but the rest is pretty trash. 6716, leave it here. Douglas and Harden gloves could be nice, but I'm not loving the rolls overall. It's too low in my opinion. Then we got the knee pads from Providence. Could be nice, roll that weapon handling away, but then still, the rest isn't that high. Just go for the open world to leave it here. 8.3% blind death resistance, 4.9% skill haste for your mine, 4.3% deflector damage, 7.8% speed for your firefly, and 6% duration for your decoy. Not that great again. Let's move over to the DZs. And for the first DZ, guys, DZs, the Carnage is the first weapon, leave it here. Model 700, leave it here. Custom L86, no thank you. Future Initiative Mask, if you're still looking for it, pick it up. For example, for the Regulus project, but I think most of y'all already did this. Just leave it here, you can craft it right now. True Patriot holster could be nice, but I would love to see that armor a little bit higher and you don't want that headshot damage on there. China Light could be nice, but then roll that weapon handling away, but you need to go for a crit skill build. And I don't know if you like to have China Light on a crit skill build, but that's my opinion. Then we got the holster from Grupo. Too low in my opinion. If you're still looking for this, roll that weapon handling away, because at 8.5% hazard protection could be nice. 10.3% skill haste, 7.9% enchant duration, 4% range for your hive, and 6.2% cone size for your pulse, and 5.6% duration for your shock traps. Nothing great again. Let's head over to the next DZ. And there we are, guys, at DZ South. First thing is the Glory Days, just leave it here. Black Market T821, just leave it here, just like all the rest of the guns, you know my opinion. Negotiator's Dilemma Backpack could be nice, but I would love to see the weapon damage a little bit higher, because you don't want that weapon handling on there. Then we got the Spear Vest. Just leave it here, guys, too low in my opinion. Or if you like that 10% critical hit damage on there, roll that weapon damage a little bit higher. Then we got the Badger Tough with almost a 9.9% status effect, so 0.1% array from the cap on this backpack, but not that great if you ask me. And then we got the Fenris Vest, guys, with 14.5% weapon damage, very nice with that headhunter, but the rest isn't that great. If your build can handle that 3.5% critical hit chance, roll that weapon handling away for some critical hit damage or whatever your build needs, of course. 4.4% critical hit chance, 4.9% damage reduction for your drone, 5.8% skill haste for your turret, and 6.2% damage for your sticky payload. Over to the last DZ, guys, and let's see if he can sell us something worth traveling for. And for our last DZ, guys, DZ West, first thing we can pick up is the Sokolov Concern Firm Handshake. Not that great. That 15% status effect will always be there. You don't want that health on there, and the weapon damage is too low. Weapons, no thank you. Maybe did 17% critical hit damage the max cap, but then again, 101 DZ credits where you can only keep 300 at a time, no thank you. Eclipse Protocol could be nice with a 9.1% explosive resistance on there, but you would love to see some status effect or even skill haste on here. Striker, not that great, 10.1% weapon damage and 4k armor regeneration. Then we got the Providence gloves, just leaving there. Knee pads from Badger, not great. 8.6% disrupt resistance, 6.3% health for your mine, 4.3% holster regeneration for your shield, 1 max target, and 6% duration for your decoy. So that's it for Washington and the DZs. Let's see what New York has to offer us, and maybe he can save this week's vendor reset. I don't think so. And for Marco, our first vendor, the Black Market AKM is the first thing he sells us. Not that great. If you like this gun, and if you are looking for this combination roll that swaps speed away, Infantry MG5 could be a decent one, but I'm not loving the swap speed, and the 10% LMG damage and 9% damage to target out of cover are too low in my opinion. The rest, as guns, isn't that great. Just leave this here. This is not great as well. Maybe this one, but then again, no thank you. 10.1% skill haste, 16.8% incoming repair, cluster mine, 6% radius, and 6% duration. No thanks, this is even worse than DC. Let's see if the last fender will save this week's fender reset, guys. First thing is the MK16, SOCOM MK20, UC15, M45A1, Walker and Harris Fast, no. Maybe this one, but then again, you don't like that critical hit chance or that crit build with some Murakami, in my opinion. Then we got a decent Mask of Overlord. Then again, if you like this, roll the weapon handling away, you have a pretty decent one. 16.2% repair skills, 11% protection from elites, 1% damage bonus for your shield, 1 extra max target, and 5.9% duration for your traps. And before I end this video, guys, I don't usually do this, but I want to give a quick shout out to my man Bear Essentials with Bear Buyers. This small content creator, only 300 subs, takes the time to review us all. Yes, guys, every content creator on the division gets ranked every week. Check him out. He is a small content creator and gives shoutouts every week and does a pretty good job. Thanks again, man. Appreciate it. But that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course, the notification bell. Pure Prime out.